Today we're here to celebrate the launch of the Smaldene viaduct, which is the heaviest and longest viaduct we've launched at HS2. It's a 4,500 tonne structure. The really unique thing is we're launching it all in one go. We'll be launching the entire viaduct over a road and a railway.
So we've had to do an enormous amount of work. We assembled it quite slowly in sizes of elements which are able to go on the highway. So 29 metres is our longest girder. There's 26 of them in total, plus 30 plus diaphragms and 312 fins, which all get welded together on site. And now we're undertaking the launch of the bridge deck onto the permanent supports, which are the piers and abutments around the road and the railway. The bridge deck itself is about 350 metres long, 11 metres-ish wide at the top, and it weighs 4,320 tonnes in its launch state.
What's made this really challenging, though, is that we're moving the viaduct over a road and a railway, a very busy A road, the A413. So that's been fraught with challenges throughout the entire project.
We are also launching this in a fairly unique way by using a strand jack system. So there's some high tensile strands which are linked to the strand jack at the back of the deck. They're tied into an anchor point at the south abutment. We then pull on those strands and that propels the bridge forwards. And the bridge slides on some low friction pads between the launch supports and the deck itself. And that's what makes the system very simple and easy to do just by simply sliding it on these pads and over the road and railway. It's around 10 metres an hour. That's not a linear speed. There's a lot of stopping, resetting things to get it moving again. But on average, you can work about 10 metres an hour.
So once the viaduct is in its final resting place on its permanent bearings, we'll then pour the deck and install the parapets on top. One of the advantages of moving the entire viaduct all in one go is that we've only had to close this major road once. We've done a few small night closures in the past, but by building the viaduct all offline and launching it all in one go, we've minimised the disruption to local road users and to local residents. And the same for rail possessions. We've minimised the number of rail possessions we've needed. In fact, some of the rail possessions we utilised were ones that Network Rail had already planned in anyway.
So day one was at the beginning of the launch. We had to launch it to about 70 metres so that we took it up to the road. Day two, we were able then to close the road and thus allowing us to launch the viaduct further over the road and get the nose over the road and land it on the central piers. We'll hand the road back and people will be driving under the bridge. Day three and day four, we have a possession of the railway. We will then push the bridge over the railway, and then once we get the bridge into its final location, the trains will start running again under this new piece of infrastructure that will be here for the next 120 years.
So there's a few things that make this unique. The alignment of the structure is actually on a curve, so we've been able to set our launch supports out on that same curve, and then we've got small guides which keep it on the right alignment as it goes from pier to pier and support to support.
Another unique feature of the viaduct is its twin composite structure, and as you can see, it's a steel that's quite unique with the fins on it as well. That steel is designed to weather over time, and it actually hardens and darkens over time. And one of the sort of nice aesthetic features of it is it's got that kind of retro Victorian era look combined with modern day concrete.
I'm immensely proud of the team. They have been focused on this weekend for many, many years. And to get here and see it all happen is an immensely proud day. And the team have done immensely well.
It was several years ago that we were stood on this very spot that we were talked about and planned that we were going to aim to get this viaduct launched in the spring of 2025. And here we are in January, launching early. And it will only be a matter of years before we'll see high-speed trains running across here to 200 miles an hour, with the aim of improving journey times between London and Birmingham, and that we free up some of that capacity on the southern end of the West Coast Main Line.